Hello everyone. In today's lecture, we are going to study about Booth's multiplication algorithm from the unit computer arithmetic. The Booth's algorithm gives a procedure for multiplying binary numbers in the binary integers in the form of sine 2's complement, right? So if the numbers are represented in the sine 2's complement format, then we can apply the Booth's multiplication algorithm for multiplying two integers, right? So first of all, we'll see the flowchart. Right, the flowchart of multiplication algorithm. Then we'll see one example. Right, so first we start with the flowchart. So it's a multiply operation, right? So we are having in a multiplication operation, we are having multiplicand and multiplier, right? So what we need to do, we need to store the multiplicand in BR, right? That is my one of the register, and multiplier in QR, right? That is my another register, right? Then what I need to do next step, in the next step, I have to assign the value 0 to the accumulator. That means I'm clearing the accumulator, right? After that, I'm assigning QN plus 1, right? I'm having QR of N bit, right? So QN plus 1 bit, I'm assigning that bit to 0, right? And then I'm having SC, that is sequence counter, and I'm assigning the value N to the sequence counter. But what is N? N, that is a number of bits of integer numbers, right? Then we are going to check QN and QN plus 1, right? If your QN and QN plus 1, that is 0, 1, right? Then what we need to do, we need to add the BR, right? Whatever the value is there in BR register, we are adding that in accumulator and storing it in a AC, right? Again, if I'm having 0, 1, then what I'm going to do, I'm adding the value in BR, right? Whatever value BR is having, I'm adding that value to the accumulator, right? And again, the storing the value in the accumulator only, right? If the value is 10, then instead of simple addition, what we are going to do, we are going to subtract the value, right? So how subtraction take place? So first of all, we have to take the 2's complement, right? So for that, we need to take 1's complement of BR plus 1, right? So ultimately, it's AC minus BR, right? So we are complementing BR and plus 1. That means we are taking 2's complement of BR and adding it in accumulator and storing it in AC, right? After both of the step, the common step we are having that we have to perform the arithmetic shift right operation for AC and QR, right? AC and QR, we have to perform the arithmetic shift right operation, right? And that is common, right? And if the value of QN and QN plus, that is 0, 0 and 1, 1, either it can be 0, 0 or it can be 1, 1, then what we need to do simply, there is no addition, no subtraction, simply we have to perform the arithmetic shift right operation, right? So this arithmetic shift right operation is a common operation that we need to perform, right? After this, we have to decrement our sequence counter, right? And then we are checking the sequence counter whether it is 0 or not. If sequence counter is 0, then we have to end this operation. And if it is not equal to 0, then again we need to check with QN, QN plus 1, right? So, this is the flowchart. I hope you all understand this, right? Now, we take one example, right? So, before taking the example, I'll write down those things, right? So, if my QN, QN plus 1, right, that is 0, 0 or 1, 1, then simply I have to perform ASHR, right, of AC and QR, right? If it is a 0, 1, then I have to perform addition operation, that is AC plus BR. And if it is 1, 0, then I have to perform subtraction operation, that is AC, AC plus BR bar plus 1. So, this is minus BR, right? So, this I am summarizing here, right? Now, let us take one example. So, let us take the value 7 into 3, right? I want to perform the 7 into 3, that is 21. Right, I know the answer, but I have to perform this. I want to perform this in using a Booth's algorithm. Right, so first of all, I need to convert this into binary form. So 7, that is 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, triple 1, that is my 7, and 3, that is 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, that is 3 in binary form. Right, Now for performing this, I'm creating one table kind of thing, so it will be easy to trace the values, right? So first I'm having the value of AC, then I'm having QR, then QN plus 1, then BR, then SC, right? Now what I need to do, that I need to store this multiplicand in BR. As we see here, that multiplicand in BR and multiplier in QR, right? So this is my multiplicand, so I'm storing it over here, that is 0111, right? And then this is my multiplier, I'm storing it over here, that is 0011, right? Now in the first step itself, we are clearing the accumulator. So my accumulator is 0000, and again my QN plus 1, that is also 0, right? This is in the first step of the flowchart, right? And then I'm assigning the SC to the N, right? We are having like this, SC N. So what is the value of N here? We are having 4 bit of data, right? So that is 4. Now what I need to do, I need to check the value QN, QN plus 1. So this is my QN and this is my QN plus 1, right? So it's a 10, right? Now if we check here, so if it is a 10, then what I need to do, I need to add, ultimately we need to subtract, but before that I need, for doing subtraction, what I need to do, that is I need to add the 2's complement of BR, right? So I need to consider 2's complement. So I am having BR, that is 0111, so first I am taking 1's complement, that is 1000, plus 1, so it's my 2's complement, so 1001. Now I'm adding this 2's complement to AC. Now right now my AC is 0000, so I'm having this 1001, right? Then QR as it is, QN plus 1 as it is, BR as it is, right? And SC, that is by default, here abhi tak humne SC mein kuch change nahi kiya hai, right? So now what we need to do, we need to check again after this subtraction, what we need to do, that is a common step. After this also I have to perform ASHR, and after this also I have to perform ASHR. That is a common step in all the cases, right? So what I need to do, that is ASHR of AC and QR. Now AC and QR, that means I am performing right shift. So this one will be shifted over here, this one will be shifted over here, here I am having 0 0, this one will be shifted over here, right? Here I am having 0 0 1, and if I am doing arithmetic right shift, that means last beat is repeated, right? So 1 1 0 0 1 0 0 1 and 1, here I am having 0 1 1 1. Now there is a need to decrement the sequence counter, so decrement it, that is 4 minus 1, that is equal to 3, right? Now I have to check the sequence counter whether it is a 0 or not. No, it's not 0, right? So again what we need to do, we need to compare this QN, QN plus 1, so it's a 1 1, right? So 1 1, that means what? Simply I have to perform ASHR, that is arithmetic right shift, and decrement your SC, right? So if I perform arithmetic right shift again, this one will be passed over here, 1 0 0 1 0 0 1 1, and again I'm repeating this value, so it's a 1, right? Now again this is 0 1 1 1, and then I need to decrement it, so it's a 2, right? Now in the again I need to check the sequence counter whether it is 0 or not. No, it is not 0, right? So again I have to check QN, QN plus 1, that's a 0 1, right? Now it's a 0 1, that means what I need to do, I need to add, right? Simple addition operation, that means I'm adding BR to my AC, right? And then I need to perform ASHR, right? So first of all I'm adding, right? So my AC is 1 1 1 0, and my BR is 0 1 1 1, right? So I'm getting 1 1 1 0, carry 1, triple 1, 1, carry 1, 1, 1, 0, carry 1. Now this carry is discarded, right? So I am getting 0, 1, 0, 1. So 0, 1, 0, 1, right? And here I am having 0, 1, 0, 0, here again 1, here 0, triple 1, right? Now what I need to do, I have already performed the addition, then I need to shifted, right? That is again arithmetic right shift. So I am having the 0 over here. Okay, this 0 here, this 1, 0, this 1 over here, 0, 1, 0, and I need to repeat this value, so it's a 0, right? And along with this, what I need to do, that is decrement say my sequence counter, that is 2 minus 1, it's a 1, right? Now again I need to check whether it is 0 or not, right? So it's not 0. So I need to compare this value, that is Qn, Qn plus 1, that's a 0, 0, right? So 0, 0 means what? I need not to perform any operation addition or subtraction. Directly we need to go for the arithmetic right shift, right? So if you go for the arithmetic right shift, this 0 will be shifted over here. I'm having 1, then 0, then 1, then 0, then 1. 0, 0, and again I'm repeating this, so it's a 0, right? Here I'm having 0, 1, 1, 1, and one sequence counter is decremented, now it's a 0, right? Now we need to check the sequence counter, is it 0? Yes, it is 0. Now what we need to do, so whatever answer I'm holding in my AC and QR, that is my correct answer, right? So let us check. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, right? So if we consider, if we convert this in a binary form, right? So it's a 2 raised to 0 plus 2 raised to 2 plus 2 raised to 4. So it's a 1 plus 4 plus 16, that is 21. And I'm already getting this answer, 7 into 3, that is 21. So 7 into 3, that is 21. So we got the correct answer. Now in the previous example, my both numbers are positive numbers. So I got the answer in the positive one, right? Now what happened if my one number is positive and one number is negative, right? So this example is about the multiplication of two numbers of different signs, right? So first I'm having one number that is plus 15, right? And the second number that is minus 13, and I need to perform the arithmetic multiplication of these two numbers, right? So for that, first of all, I need to convert this, right? So if I convert this plus 15, that is 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, that is plus 15, right? Now minus 13, as you know that minus 13 is a negative number, and we represent it in a 2's complement form. So first of all, I need to perform, I need to convert the plus 13. So plus 13, that is a 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, that is my plus 13, right? So for converting the in a negative form, what I need to do, I need to apply the 2's complement. So first is the 1's complement, that is 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, plus 1. So I'm getting 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, sorry, 1, 1, right? So what I'm having, that is 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. So minus 13, that is 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. Here I am taking it as a 5 bit number. Why? Because whatever answer I am getting, that is a 3 digit number, right? So for that I am taking this as a 5 bit number, right? Now if we do, like if we follow the flow chart, right? So first of all, I'll create some table, right? So that is AR, AC, QR, QN plus 1, right? BR and SC. Now SC, as you know, sequence counter, that is number of bits, so it is initiated with 5, right? Qn plus 1, that's a 0, and AC, that again initiated with 0, right? So 0. Now what we need to do, we need to store the multiplicand in BR and multiplier in QR, right? So here plus 15, that is my multiplicand, so I'm storing it over here in BR, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. And minus 13, that is multiplier, so I am storing it over here, that is 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. Now, what I need to do, I need to check Qn and Qn plus 1, right? So my Qn, that is 1, and Qn plus, that is 0, so 1, 0, right? So if I am having 1, 0, so what I need to do, so I need to add the 2's complement of BR to the AC, right? So 2's complement of BR, that is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, right? 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, that is 1's complement plus 1. So I'm getting 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, right? So I'm adding this number, right? into AC, so I'm getting 10001. Here I'm having 10011, and here I'm having 001111. Now what I need to do after performing the addition, right? That is ultimately the subtraction operation. What I need to, what is the common step? That is arithmetic shift right operation, right? So what I need to do, I need to shift right. So this one will be over here, 1 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 1, and I'm repeating this value because it's an arithmetic shift. So I'm repeating the last value, so it's a 1, right? Now along with this, what I need to do, that is I need to decrement my sequence counter. That is 5 minus 4, that's a 5 minus 1, that's a 4, right? So now again we need to check the sequence counter whether it is 0. No, it's not 0, right? So what I need to do, we need to check Qn plus 1. So Qn plus 1, that's a 1 1, right? So if it is a 1 1 or a 0 0, right, either it is 0 0 or a 1 1, then we need to perform only arithmetic shift right operation, right? So we are shifting it right. So 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 0 1 1, and again I'm repeating this value, so it's a 1, right? So it's a 0 1 1 1 1, and again my sequence counter is decremented, so 4 minus 1, that's a 3, right? Now after this, what I need to do, again I need to check. So it's a 0 1, right? So if it is a 0 1, that I have to perform the actual addition operation, right? So I need to add BR to the AC, right? So I'm having 1 1 1 0 0 plus 0 1 1 1 1. So what I'm getting, that is 1 1 1 1 0 carry 1 triple 1 carry 1 1 1 0 carry 1. Now this carry is discarded, so I'm getting 0 1 0 1 1. So 0 1 0 1 1, right? Here I'm having 0 1 1 0 0, here I'm having 1 0 1 1 1 and a 1, right? Now after performing addition, again I need to do arithmetic shift right. So here I'm getting 0 0 1 1, then I'm getting 0 1 1, then 0 1 0, and I'm repeating this value, so again it's a 0, right? So it's a 0 0 1 0 1. Here I'm having 1 0 1 1 0 0, here I'm being 0 1 1 1 1. Here I need to decrement the sequence counter, that is 3 minus 1 2. Now what I need to check, 2, whether it is 0 or not. Sequence counter is not 0, so again I need to repeat, right? So again it's a 0 0. 0 0 means what? We need to perform arithmetic shift right operation. So if we perform arithmetic shift right operation, so I need I'll get 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 0, then 0, and again I'm repeating this value, so it's a 0, right? And then 0 1 1 1 1, again I'm decrementing, right? So 2 minus 1, that's a 1, right? Now what I need to do, again I need to check Qn plus 1, that's a 1 0, right? So if it is a 1 0, then what we need to do, that is we need to add the 2's complement of BR, right? So 2's complement of BR, so that is 1 0 0 0 1. This is 2's complement of BR. I need to add this to 0 0 0 1 0. So what I'm getting, that is 1 1 0 0 1. So I'm getting 1 0 0 1 1, right? So 1 0 0 1 1, here I'm having 1 1 0 1 1, here I'm having 0 0 1 1 1 1. Now after applying the 2's complement, adding the 2's complement to the AC, what I need to do, that is arithmetic shift right operation. So I'm shifting it towards right. So 1, then here 1 0 1 1 1 1 0 0, then 1, and again I'm repeating this value, so it's a 1, right? So what I'm getting, that is 1 1 0 0 1 triple 1 0 1, right? Here 0 1 1 1 1, and I need to decrement, so 1 minus 1, that's a 0. Now if we check the sequence counter, that is it is equal to 0, that means I need to add. So whatever I am getting over here, that is my answer. But there is a problem, right? What is the problem? Because here there is no overflow, right? I am adding, I am multiplying one positive number and one negative number. So my sign is negative. Ultimately my sign is negative, right? And here I am not getting any overflow. That means what? Whatever answer I am getting, that is a negative answer, right? So negative answer, to get the original answer, what I need to do? I need to perform 2's complement, right? 2's complement of what? Whatever answer I am getting, right? So first of all, I will write it down over here. That is 11001. 111001, right? Now after this, what I need to perform? 1's complement. So that's a 00110000010 plus 1. Why? Because this is 1's complement plus 1. So I'll getting 2's complement, right? So it's a 00110000011. Right? Now if you convert this, in a binary form, that is 195, and that is the answer of 15 into 13, that is a 195. But here my one number is negative, that means I'll get minus 195. So minus 195 means what? I'm getting the answer in the 2's complement form, that means it's a negative answer. Right? Clear? So I hope you all are clear about this example, right? In a previous example, we took both the number as a positive, right? Here my one number is positive and one number is negative, right? Clear? Thank you very much.